Daleks? Yes. But how? The Daleks abandoned Skaro years ago. What are they doing here?
Unless they were here all the time.
Davros, how did you get back here?
Skaro is an invader, but I have you here.
Where did you get all these Daleks?
I already told you. They never left.
Well, what about the other Daleks? How do they fit into all this?
They are traitors to be cast aside and exterminated. What you see before you is my great contingency plan. Do you think that I would let a lifetime of work be shortened by spies and traitors?
The Daleks have betrayed you?
They are nothing. I knew that one day my own creation would probably revolt against me. And so, I built this. And as you can see, I was right. And now the traitors shall feel the sting of my new army.
New army, eh? Those are husks, Davros. Where are you going to get the material to engineer the Dalek creatures? You stick plain old Daleks in those machines and you're asking for a revolution all over again. You can't win, Davros. You program them, and you can't recondition them.
But they can be re-engineered. And with the proper human additives, my new Daleks will not only be loyal, they shall be invincible.
Human additives? You mean...
You and your companions shall be esteemed privileged to be part of a resurrection of an empire so devastating that this time we will not fail. This time there will be no defeats. With my humanoid Daleks, nothing will be able to stand in the way of the conquest of the universe. And I shall be its supreme ruler!
Well, that's all fine and dandy, I'm sure. I see your stint on the prison bars didn't cure you of your penchant for megalomania and an overreacting personality.
Overreacting, Doctor? You see nothing yet.
That's what I was afraid of. You know, Davros, there's no Gallifreyan proverb. He who...
I've had enough of your dry-witted childish humor. I have a universe to conquer.
And I have a headache. Can we go now, Davros?
Go? I think not, Doctor. You are my prisoner now.
Davros, we've been through this how many times now? Look, you build your empire, and your Daleks, and your ego, and then we'll talk. Deal?
Deal? Ha! I don't make deals. Sentries, watch the prisoners. If they try to escape, exterminate them. I have work to do. We obey!
A little rough, don't you think?
You remain here!
Don't count on it.
Guard them. I will return to Davros. I obey.
Don't leave on our account. The doctor usually isn't this room.
Dylan. Well, you're not. He's a madman, Doctor. Unbalanced, and you're egging him on as if you're enjoying it. Davros is flipped, and a right smack in the middle of it.
Landon, I'm not being rude. I'm being realistic. He may be unbalanced, which right now is all too obvious. But he's also so full of hot air that if this place didn't have a ceiling, he'd probably be in orbit by now. I've heard it all before.
Doctor, you're forgetting that this unbalanced, flipped-out madman is also a genius, and he can very well pull off what he intends to do. We've got to stop him.
I'm working on it. If you two would just shut up long enough...
We obey.
Now who's acting unrealistic?
Don't look at us.
Landon, you see that jar?
Yeah? What about it?
Inside is a Dalek.
In there?
Well, it's not inside the Dalek yet. Looks harmless enough to me.
But that's the beauty of it. It's not as passive as it looks. See those markings? And the tail?
Yeah.
Davros' meager experiments were capable of bending 4-inch plated steel bars and breaking concrete slabs as if they were paper.
What are you going to do?
I think our Dalek friend has just bought us a ticket out of here.
A tricorder reading of this area over here, I suppose.
Hey, Captain! Captain!
Yes, what is
over
it
here?
Again? What?
Look down there. It looks like some sort of settlement. I can at least 100 or so people down there. What are you supposed to do here?
I didn't expect to find anything on this planet resembling civilization.
Should we take a look?
Fan out! Let's keep a low posture.
Isaac,
find out what's going on over there.
Right, move it over there, a little more.
Captain Ramsey,
The man looks like he's wearing her.
Okay, yes, sit it down. There you go. Now lock it in place. Hey, you. You.
Yes.
Yes, what is it?
Come here.
Can I help you?
Is that a garrison uniform you're wearing?
Well, yes, it is. Wait a minute. You're not part of the North Coast. You're garrison.
Captain Ramsey. Third Galactic Fleet. Galaxy Garrison.
Tyson, I've been here over 2 years.
You're from the Paladin, aren't you?
Yes.
We thought that ship was lost with all hands.
Ghost hands, yes. There were a few of us when we were taken captive by Daleks, who were forced in slave labor to try to find their creator, and... Well, here I am.
Haven't you made any contact with the fleet? What are you still doing
here? We've got no radios. We've got no way to contact.
You seem to be doing very well for yourself.
Well, we've certainly been trying, ever since Davros was captured and taken back to Earth by the Dr. Fowl. No, I haven't seen Heim or Herring for a long time. What are you doing here, Captain?
It's about Davros.
What about him?
He escaped.
What?
I believe he came to Skaro.
Skaro?
We don't know why, but we're here to get him. Have you seen anything unusual? Heard any noises? Any strange ships flying by?
No, not at all. But we've mainly been keeping to our own business.
Nothing unusual?
No, not that I can say. But if Davros is back, then everything that we've been working for is threatened.
Now relax. I hope to have him off of this planet soon enough. It's strictly an in-and-out mission. I don't intend to waste any time here. Listen, Tyson. We're gonna scan out about this way. Over the hills and down into the valley. Who wouldn't mind if I leave a few sentries here just to keep an eye on things?
No. In fact, I'd rather say we need...
We don't intend to interfere with your construction or anything here.
I understand, Captain.
If you see anything strange, let them know and they'll give the message to me.
Yes, sir.
Keep an eye. We don't know who's who.
Well, that's for sure.
Stevenson?
Yes, sir.
Michaels?
Yeah.
You're on sentry here. Stay out of Tyson's way. We keep in constant contact.
Aye, sir. Aye, sir.
Captain?
Yes.
We might try a little east of the hills. There are some caves in there, and if Davros is hiding anywhere, it might be there. And the old bunker with the cannons is there, too. It's a little dangerous, that's why we haven't gone anywhere near it, but we've got supplies and some electrical equipment.
Good. We'll try over there, then. We'll be back in 2 centaurs. Got it?
Got it.
Got it, sir.
All right. Move out!
Daleks. And Davros. Modok must learn of this.
Scouting party returning!
Scouting party returning!
Scouting party returning!
What is the news from the surface?
Davros has returned, Modok.
No! I don't believe it.
He has. And if he's here, the Daleks are here with him.
Then the evil has started all over again. He must be stopped now while we have the time. We will launch the rocket immediately.
No, Modok!
We must!
You'll be killing innocent people! It is only with the Daleks that we have a quarrel!
We no longer have any choice. We must launch the rocket. Destroy Davros, the Daleks, and those who brought the evil to us.
But, Modok, see reason!
I am seeing reason. I see reason to step up the launch by 24 hours. We launch tomorrow, and there will be no further arguments. Is that understood?
Yes, Modok.
Good.
Doctor, can Davros really pull this off?
Of course he can. When it comes to genetics, the man's a positive genius.
Positive? There is nothing positive in that genius, Doctor. He's a madman, plain and simple.
Yes, but he's an intelligent madman, and that makes him all the more dangerous.
How can we stop him?
Well, right now we have an advantage. Although Davros has access to the genetic creatures and the Dalek cases, he doesn't have the raw energy needed to bring his army to life.
How much energy would something like that take?
For one Dalek, not much. He could probably do it now.
If he doesn't mind sacrificing the rest of the energy he's got.
That wouldn't be to his advantage. See, one of Davros' greatest weaknesses is his own ego. Everything he does is on a grand scale. Right now, he doesn't have enough energy with him to light a match. But given time, and Davros is a very patient person, we could store up enough energy to bring his entire army to life all at once.
How much time does that give us?
I don't know. He didn't exactly give us the grand tour. In the meantime, we have to get out of here and figure out a way to stop him.
How do we do that, Doctor?
There's a Dalek standing guard outside. How about that ventilator shaft?
Not another ventilator shaft, Doctor.
Would you prefer to stay behind and become a Dalek potpourri?
What about your,
sonic screwdriver?
Landon, you wouldn't happen to have a sonic screwdriver, would you?
No, I thought you had it.
Dylan?
Who, me?
Doctor, please don't tell me that you left the sonic screwdriver on the TARDIS.
We did.
We?
Well, we were working together for once on the TARDIS. Besides, it doesn't matter. I always carry spare tools somewhere in his plastic pockets. Ah, here it is.
What's that?
This is going to get our ugly little friend in here to open up that ventilator grill for us. And then we are going to get out of here.
Doctor, you're forgetting that our ugly little friend in there is a bubbling mass of hate and protoplasm. Don't think that it's going to be inclined to do us any favors.
That's what this is for. It's a Roman's clamp. It pinches the ventral nerves in the creature's neck. As long as I hold the clamp in place, I can relax the nerve and pacify the Dalek blob. When I let go,
rip, the tail yanks out the ventilator grill.
Exactly.
I still think it's a little too dangerous.
Well, there's always
the... I know. Dalek potpourri.
Right. Hold the clamp for me. Let's make it nasty.
Spaghetti.
Hit. Landon, hold him to the
car.
Take it easy.
What's that?
Oof. Hold it!
Shh. Right. Give me the clamp.
Side. On the other side.
Don't be careful, watch his tail.
I know.
Got him!
Okay.
Don't let go.
I won't. Stand back.
What are you doing? Get your elbow out of my nose.
Okay, here's the grill. We've made to get this thing open. Who's that?
That's Joe.
What is she doing here?
Hey, Susie, Joe! Joe, over here! Give us a hand here.
Right. Right. You first, Dylan.
There.
Here. Come on, Joe. Give us a hand. Come on.
What's that noise?
It's the generators. Davros must have started them up for some reason.
I think we better get out of here.
Come on, this way. Everybody down.
Everybody okay?
We're fine over here.
Good. Joe? She's fine too. Right. Let's get out of here.
Say this was a dead planet.
So
you don't think they were maybe made by
ghosts, do you?
Dylan! Looks like somebody needs a refresher course in tricedial photonics.
Never mind. Let's just see where they go. Doctor, would you mind telling me why we're following a bunch of old footprints?
Well, for one thing, they're not old, they're fresh. And whose footprints do you know of that just appear out of nowhere?
Well, how should I? Ah.
Very good, Dylan. I knew you were learning more than plasma geomics back on Canis. Obviously, whoever made these footprints had some kind of teleportation technology. And by the size of their landing party, I'd say it was military.
Military?
Doctor, what would the military want with Skaro? I don't know, yet. But anyone with an interest in Skaro, I want to know about.
Do you think this has anything to do with the Movellans?
I'm not sure. Wait a minute! Davros was being held on a military space station! If he escaped, which he did, then these must be from the people who were sent to bring him back.
Oh my.
And they have no idea what they're getting themselves into. Come on, we've got to find them before something dreadful happens. Something about your captain?
He's been captured by a Dalek.
What? Whereabouts?
Just over that rise. There's several bunkers over there where we've been getting equipment and supplies for our shelters.
Lieutenant, you are a lieutenant, right? Listen to me very carefully. Your captain's in great danger.
We know that, Doctor. Tell us something we don't already know.
All right. I think I know of a way that we can save your captain. But we have to do it now before it's too late.
What makes you think he's not dead already? We've already killed a lieutenant.
Yes, but I don't think your poor lieutenant is what this particular Dalek had in mind.
What are you talking about?
There's more at work here than you realize.
Look, Doctor, whoever you are, all I know is that our captain has just been captured by one of the most dangerous aliens in the galaxy. And the escaped criminal that created these horrors is somewhere on this planet right now. What could you possibly know that could make this situation any better off than it is now? Look, Lieutenant, whoever you are, the Doctor and I and him just escaped the clutches of your criminal refugee, and he's got more up his sleeve than just one Dalek and a captured captain.
Thanks a lot, Tim.
You know where Davros is?
Yes.
Trevor!
Yes, sir?
Everybody here?
All present and accounted for, sir.
Phasers on heavy stun. Doctor, show the way. Let's spoil this insane party before it gets any worse.
Commander, scanning indicates surface and subsurface transdata explosions. Thermal scans have detected a 68% increase in power emanations from Sector 7.
Interesting. This would bear on-site investigation. Vaughn, you and Delos explore surface Sector 7 and the surrounding area. Nova, you check Sector 7 and the underground.
Yes, Commander.
Doctor, can we go any faster?
Daleks all over the place?
If what you told me is true, we have to get him out now.
Right. The holding area where Davros held his prisoners down that way.
Hey, Doctor, didn't we pass by that hallway when the Dalek guards locked us up?
Yes, we did. Nice work, Dylan. Davros' lab is down that way. Everybody back, quick!
Experiment subject 1 complete. Commence location and capture of 3 more test subjects. Let no opposition halt you. We obey. Seek and locate. Seek and locate. Sensors indicate unauthorized movement in Sector 6.8. Intruders identified as Merlin sharpshooters. Take a patrol of the remaining Daleks and exterminate! I obey!
Alright. He's gone out the other way.
Yeah. And while his Daleks are busy with the villains, let's get our captain before Davros decides to come back.
Come on, this way.
Ready?
Ready?
Go!
Captain!
Captain!
Wait! We're too late!